Hey, Pascal here, nice to see you again on my channel, and today I will show you how to create really awesome looking hyperlapses using the DJI Osmo Pocket, and I will also give you some tips on how to make it even better. I'm actually in Sicily right now. This is an island in Italy in the very south, actually a quite big island, and this place is perfect for shooting hyperlapses simply because, well, Italy is known for beautiful architecture, and this type of hyperlapses that I want to show here is perfect for shooting buildings. So that was actually one reason why I also went here. I want to shoot more hyperlapses, and the DJI Osmo Pocket is perfect for that. There you have multiple options of shooting hyperlapses with the DJI Osmo Pocket. It has this like integrated time-lapse function, which is cool for like steady shots, but also if you want to walk for a longer distance, but it will get very jittery, I wouldn't necessarily suggest using that. You also have the motion time-lapse, which is also type of hyperlapse because the gimbal is moving while it's doing a time lapse, so it counts as a hyperlapse, but that's not what I want to show here. I want to really focus on tracking hyperlapses, where you have like one specific object in the center of the frame usually, and then you bring in some motion into the shot, which gives the hyperlapse. And yeah, that's a cool shot. So I think you already saw in the intro what I exactly mean. So you always had a building or a statue in the center, and then I was moving with the camera, and it looks always great, and really the DJI Osmo Pocket makes it so easy to do. So, but how do you shoot such a hyperlapse? Let's start with the settings first, and it's actually quite easy on the DJI Osmo Pocket because you don't have much options. You want to use tracking, and so you have to use video mode, and to really get the best quality, I suggest to shoot in 4K 24, 25 or 4K 30. You cannot shoot in 4K 60 or 4K 50 simply because then you cannot choose the tracking functionality of the Osmo Pocket, and you really need it for that. So I personally do 4K 24 because then the bitrate per frame is also a little bit higher, so it increases the quality a little bit, but not really that you would notice that, like it's a very small difference, but I shoot always in 24, and so I also do it like that there, and I would suggest you doing that. And apart from that, you want to use the pro mode because there you can set it to cine-like, and cine-like gives you a bit more options with the colors, and also it's not so over sharp. Like the normal mode is a bit sharper than the cine-like mode, and I don't want to have it too sharp. So that's basically everything already. Like just set it to video mode, 4K 24, 4K 25, 30, and use cine-like colors to really get the best quality. That's all for the settings. And what you also want to do before starting the hyperlapse, you want to connect it to your phone, because that makes it a lot easier shooting, and especially using the tracking functionality. And what's also important, of course, is that you don't just look for the object, but you also look before where you want to walk. Like in this shot that I show right now with a statue in the middle, I could simply walk in a circle around it. That always looks nice with such hyperlapses, but especially with bigger buildings, when you're a bit farther away, or you have to walk a bit farther away to get a decent shot of it, then it can sometimes be a bit complicated to have a good walkable way. So really think of that before and you run into something. Yeah, and after that you can just track the object, and what I also suggest doing here is to put the object not completely in the center of the frame, but put it a bit more to the left or the right depending on where you want to go. Like if the object is left from you, you want to put it a bit more to the right, and if the object is right from you, you want to put it a bit more to the left part, because usually it doesn't start tracking directly. It usually takes like I don't know just a few millimeters on the display until it starts tracking, and so then you get it perfectly in the center when you actually set it a bit off center before. Like this is a very important tip. Like my first hyperlapses were actually a bit like out of the center because of that, because I just kept it in the center at first. So make sure that it's not perfectly in the center before. And yeah, when you got that, then you can simply walk the path that you looked before, and you do the tracking like normal. And Like, to really get the perfect result, you should actually do what I mentioned in the other video. I will link this video here, and in this video I show you how you can get a bit smoother footage with the DJI Osmo Pocket. And yeah, you can simply apply those same tricks also to the hyperlapse, but of course if you want to walk very long distances, then it wouldn't work so good. But definitely make sure that you walk as smooth as possible so that your footage gets smooth. And for that I also have one more tip for you, and that is simply that, especially when you have bigger objects like a church, tower or whatever, then simply pull your gimbal a bit up in the air, because this bumps when you walk, you can't see them so much when the gimbal points up, right? So that actually makes it very easy to shoot those hyperlapses without getting too many jitters there, even if you just walk normally. Like, actually the shot that I blend in right now, I just walked normally. I did not like walk especially slow or like with short steps or anything like that, like I mentioned in the other video. I really just walked normally, and it looked so good after that. Like, the Osmo Pocket makes it so easy, especially if you point it a little bit up. Okay, and after you shut your hyperlapse, it's time to go into the editing. So just drag it into your timeline, and then you want to speed it up to actually make a hyperlapse out of it, because right now it's just a normal video, right? It's a bit long. So I usually speed it up to 600 until 1500%, depending on the length of the clip and how the motion looks and so on. Like, just play a bit around with it and make sure that it looks good. And what I then also do usually is to do with it is that I add some stabilization in post. You can do that in Final Cut, but there are also options in Premiere and DaVinci Resolve. Actually, DaVinci Resolve has some of the best stabilization I've ever seen on a video editor. So you can really use every video editor you want for that, at least the better editors, like not Windows Movie Maker, of course. And what I also do, and this is actually my second tip, like the first tip was pointing that up. Second tip here, to make your hyperlapse is even better with the DJI Osmo Pocket, is to add motion blur. In Final Cut Pro 10, that's not included by default, like at least not the type of motion blur that I want to use here. In Final Cut Pro 10, you have to use a plugin. It's actually free. You can download either a plugin from Ryan Nangle or from Mark Webster. Then you can simply add it to your clip, or you can use it like a title effect, and it adds the motion blur, and that makes it look so good. So just look at the clip right now without motion blur. And now look at the clip with motion blur. It looks so much better, right? So motion blur really adds so much to hyperlapses, so definitely add it. And I know, like, you like free stuff, right? So if you use DaVinci Resolve, you have to get the paid version to add those kind of motion blur. So yeah, you have to get a paid software, paid video editor for that. But even if you can't add motion blur for that reason, then it's not a big deal. Like, it still looks nice, but just motion blur like gives it this extra percent, and I really love it. So, and that's everything already. Like, after that, of course, you can do some color grading, and I have other videos for that, so just watch them. But yeah, that's everything. You have a great hyperlapse now, and I really love it how the DJI Osmo Pocket does it. It makes it so easy. Like, sometimes I was like, in that shot that I'm showing right now, I was just walking there, like mentioned before. Like, it took me like 1 minute to get this hyperlapse, and it's great. But what I also want to mention here is that I wouldn't say this is like those real epic hyperlapses always, because this is not an hyperlapse where you see so much movement in the clouds or so on. Like, I also like hyperlapses that are taken over maybe 20 minutes or an hour or so, because there you cannot simply see like the camera moving around a building or whatever, but you can also see like movement in the clouds, or everything around is moving a bit faster. Maybe the lightning changes, the sun goes down or whatever. And for that kind of hyperlapse, the DJI Osmo Pocket is not the ideal camera. But for like this type of hyperlapse that you saw here right now, of the cloud movement and so on, it's not that important, then the Osmo Pocket is actually a great tool. So what are your thoughts? Did you already shoot some hyperlapses with the DJI Osmo Pocket? Leave it in the comments below. What are your experiences? And also make sure to hit the subscribe button right now. I publish one tutorial every Sunday, so you can actually learn a lot more on this channel in the future. So see you in the next video.